If you've ever struggled to simulate realistic welding in Abaqus, especially using the Goldak double ellipsoid heat source, you're not alone. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to implement the DFLUX subroutine step by step and explain what most tutorials skip. Whether you're new to welding simulations or trying to refine your heat source model, this is the walkthrough you've been looking for. Oh, and I've included the DFLUX subroutine code and the complete Abaqus model. Just check the description for the download link. Let's get started. Go to the part, 3D deformable solid extrusion, 0.2 would be okay. Now we want to create a rectangle. This is the rectangle. Let's put this guy on 0.025. This one 0.05. Down and 0.50. And this is the part we have. Now let's create partition here. For this purpose, I click on partition face sketch, select this one, and vertical right. I just need two lines here, like this, because I want to refine the mesh here in the center where the flux moves. Okay, now we need to extrude that. Left click and hold and select this one, partition cell, extrude slash sweep. So select this one by holding shift. You can select the other one, done, sweep along edge, this one, and create partition. Okay, we need to have the flux here and moves in this region. Now we can go to the property, create materials properties. We need general density, temperature dependent. We need thermal conductivity, temperature dependent. And we need a specific heat, temperature dependent. Now let's go to the Excel file. If you go to the FEAmaster.com, from shop material properties package, I have the materials properties here for free. You can add it to the cart and download it for free. Once the order is completed, you can download it from here. So I want to open this file. Right here I can enable editing to copy and paste them. Control C. This is for the density, conductivity, and specific heat. This is the material properties we need. And now we need to create a section. The section must be solid, homogeneous, and okay. It should be material one. And we can assign it to this one. I uncheck this. Okay, as it turns green, it means the section is assigned. Now let's go to the assembly. I assembled the model here. Now I need to translate it. I want to translate it from here to here. Scroll button. I reset the view. So the reason I translate it to here is because in my code I want to define here as a starting point, which is the 000, and it's easier for me to do that. Okay, we can go to the step. We need to create a step. The step should be heat transfer, comes after the step initial, continue. The time period can be 25. So this one is better to be 1 million. So this can be 0.1. 1e minus 10 is enough. And that can be 1. This can be 350. Okay, now we're almost done. We go to the field output. We only need the nodal temperature. We don't need the heat flux, we don't need anything, just the nodal temperature. Now this step is also done. Let's go to the interaction. We need to create the interaction. The first interaction I want to create is in step one and is surface film condition. I want to create the surface here because I need it for the next one. I select everything, then rotate it. By holding control, you can uncheck the bottom part. And done. So it should be property reference, and from here I can create properties, and as this is the film condition, I can go to the continue and create the film condition. Here I need the surface film coefficient, copy, jump back to Abaqus and paste. Okay, the sink temperature can be 25, interaction properties, and this is a film condition. Okay, now we need to create another one, which is surface radiation. You can select it from surfaces here, surface one. If you hit on highlight, you can see the part you selected. Continue, the emissivity must be 0.49 and the ambient temperature is 25. Okay, I reset the view and we're done with the interaction. Now it's time to go to the load. Alright, now let's create the load. Here I said create load, step one, and put it on body heat flux and select this one, uncheck this one, done. I want to use the user defined. As you see, when I click the user defined, it says user subroutine deflux must be attached to the analysis job. I'll put the value of 1 and hit OK. And as you see here, the load is created. Now we need to go to the predefined field, create one. It can be a step initial, temperature, continue, and we select everything, done. Direct specification and put the magnitude of 25, and this is the predefined temperature. It means when you start the simulation, the initial temperature is 25. Okay, now we're done with the load. Let's go to the mesh. Okay, now we put this on part. The global mesh size can be 0.002. And okay, we need to seat the edges. By holding shift, I select these four and these four. I want to have 40 elements here, and on this one, the one in the bottom here, this one and this one, I can have 6 elements and done. And here, 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 and every line which is parallel to it, we need to have 4 elements. And done. Let's mesh it and see how it goes. Actually, the meshes, the elements here are a little big, but it's okay for now. Now let's go to assign element type, select everything, and go all the way down and select the heat transfer and click on OK. Now this is the time to write down the code. First thing first, we need to open the Visual Studio. So we go continue without code, and from here, file, new, and file. I want to create Intel Fortran and .4 file. I open it. Now this is the file I have. Now we need to go to the Abaqus documentation. Now here in Abaqus, if you go all the way down to the user subroutines, and we need the Abaqus standard user subroutines and deflux, This is the code for the DFLUX, so I always recommend you to copy and paste it from here. Don't trust any other sources. Then you go back here and paste it. As you see here, we have subroutine DFLUX, and here is where we need our code. So this is the code. We have the coordinates x, y, z, and we have the heat source center. We have x, y, and z here, but for xc, we have x0 plus v, which is the welding speed, times t. So in this manner, the flux would move. And here we have the Goldak parameters. So these parameters are for the ellipsoid, a, c, pf, pr. If we take a look at this image of the Goldak double ellipsoid, you see here we have the front and the rear ellipsoids, and we have A, B, and C. So as our coordinates are not the same as this one, we have two B's. So here we have BF and BR, and we have A and C, and this is F forefront and F rear, which is one coefficient, and the summation of these two coefficients should be 2. So if we take a look at this article and we go all the way down to these equations, we have this equation for the front and we have this one for the back. Actually, the front would pass through the temperature and the rear ellipsoid maintain it. Here we have for the x bigger than 0, and here we have this one for the x's less than 0. And this is the fraction FR over BR and FF over BF. And as you see here, the FF plus FR must be 2. They also provided the table including A, C, BF, and everything else. I took FF and FR from them, but I wanted to have my modified version of the A, C, and BR. In other words, the ellipsoid, so I changed the numbers. You are allowed to change the numbers for your model as well. So let's go back to the article. Let's go back to the code here. We have the heat input parameters. The eta here is 0.8 VI, so basically we have the Q out of it, and here we have the QR and QF. Let's go back to the paper to see that. Here, actually, this is the part before the EXP term, and we have this one. So this is the equation for that, QR and QF. Here we have the rear half. This is the code for it. If the X is less than or equal to XC, we would have this one. And as a result, the flux would be this one, QR times the EXP. We basically put the equation of the QR here. And we have an end if here, and there's an else if here. If x is greater than xc, we will have this equation here for the flux, and the flux 2 is 0. You might wonder what this end would be. So if I cut it and paste it here, you see it turns into a comment and it cannot fit there. So we put it here and we place an and, or we can place one, or we can place a star here in order to define that this is the next line in continue of the previous line. And that's pretty much everything. If you need the code, just visit the website. I put the link for you in the description. All right, we save this one and we go back to the Abaqus to run the job. But before creating and running the job, I want to ask you a favor. If you enjoyed this video so far, please leave a comment for me down below. It's totally free for you, but helps me creating videos like this. Before we submit the job, we need to go to the model, edit attributes, and model 1. This is -273.15, and Stefan Boltzmann is 5.669 -8. Okay, we go to the job, create the job. I would like to name that welding DFLUX dist and continue. From here, general, we use user subroutine file, and here I have the Goldak.4. We need to submit the job. Now the job is completed. Let's go take a look at the results. This is the flux in the very final second. I would like to put it back here. Plus I want to have a limit here. Maybe we can have like 2500 and okay. And this is how the flux is moving. As you see, we have a ellipsoid shape here and the flux is moving and the temperature is rising up. Yeah, that's okay. And that's in the end. Actually, let's have it here. We can have this on auto compute, and if you change it, you can see like the actual shape of the flux. But we can have a cut actually here to see how it goes. And as you see, we have this part also melted because we use the body heat flux on this one. Yeah, that's fine. Now let me uncut this one. For better visualization, we can also go to the option comment and we can have the free edges. This one looks better to me. And we can go to the viewport and annotation option. I would like to uncheck the state and title block here, so we have only the contour and the legend. Plus you can go to the legend and put this one on 10, for instance. Then you can have a good visualization. Plus you can put this one on animate history with the limit you want, like this 1500 or like 2500, like this. And from animate, if you hit the save as and put it on QuickTime or AVI and hitting OK, you can have the animation for yourself. If you want to plot the time versus temperature, we can go to the here ODB field output, continue, and put this one on unique nodal. We have nodal temperature, and we can have a node list or pick from viewport. I would like to pick this one and plot. And as you see here, we have the temperature versus time. We can select different timing and so on. That's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. And if you don't want to do the welding simulation with subroutine, click on the video before it ends. Stay tuned.